Good afternoon. It is my pleasure and indeed my honor to extend a special welcome to the 25 international honorary members joining us on this induction weekend from 17 countries. I wish also to welcome the British Consul General to New England, Harriet Cross, the Consul General of Japan in New England, Rokuricho Michi, and the Consul General of Finland in Boston, Leonard Koppelman, all of whom are with us here this afternoon. Although its name and early mission emphasize the importance of the arts and the sciences for the United States, the American Academy has never been an exclusively American enterprise. In its structure and mission, it was modeled after European learned societies, and its founders were firm in their conviction that knowledge is not limited by national borders, and that international collaboration is indispensable to human progress. Over the course of its history, the American Academy has collaborated with dozens of international academies and learned societies, and has elected honorary members in every class and section, including many whose names you will know: Lafayette, Gladstone, Ruskin, Priestley, Darwin, Einstein, Euler, Nehru, Picasso, Hawking, Leakey, Goodall, Mandela, and Amartya Sen, to name only a few. Today, the Academy recognizes those international connections, and that international connections themselves, like interdisciplinary connections, are easier to forge and more necessary than they have been at any other time in history. We are making a concerted effort to expand the geographic borders of our membership and the reach of our projects. Indeed, in the past 3 years alone, the Academy has organized 13 international convenings for members in Tel Aviv, Milan, Geneva, Edinburgh, and Abuja, Nigeria, among other cities. In addition, individual Academy projects have sponsored dozens of international meetings on topics as diverse as the responsibility to protect cultural heritage, regional solutions to nuclear waste management, and the most effective ways to respond to civil wars and global instability. We encourage our fellows and international honorary members to nominate for membership deserving candidates from all around the world, and in particular from regions that are now underrepresented in our membership, including Africa, Asia, India, the Middle East, and South America. We ask your help in strengthening our relationships with academies around the world. We urge you to consider academy initiatives to which you might like to contribute, and we hope that all of our members will find value in this fellowship for scholarly discussion, intellectual exchange, and collaboration. Congratulations to all of our international honorary members on your election, and thank you for being with us today.